people aren't prepared to do the work between the idea and the reality. That's one thing that's missing massively in society. They're not prepared to go through all the steps. There is no way to the top without passing every step on the way. You just choose the pace you can run at them, and if you get strong, you can jump a few at a time.
In fact, most of us in this room have either seen or experienced the superpowers of social media. We have seen it influence elections. We've watched it ignite revolutions. We've watched it make people's cats famous.
Basic needs of people that want respect, that love, that appreciation, everything else. These things don't change from generation to generation. We could have said the same thing 2,000 years ago. What is changing, though, is the world around us and how we communicate.
Who the heck are you doing it for? Because if I'm in Kansas City, Missouri, or if I'm in Boston, Massachusetts, those people are different. If I'm dealing with a mom with 2 kids under the age of 4, that's completely different than the person who is a retiree. We've got this. These are different customers with completely different needs. And we can't wrap them up and they're like, well, there are 4 types of people we have. No, we're talking about individual people.
We all want attention. We want attention at home and we want attention at work. And if you want attention, you have to pay attention.
The best way to deal with the changes emerging technology brings about is to focus on making human experiences more meaningful.
I know your idea is important. It needs to be important. It needs to be interesting. It needs to be individual to you.
But that does not excuse you from common courtesy. I don't care who you are. I don't care who you work for. I don't care what wings you have on your lapel. It does not excuse you from common courtesy. My mama raised me right. Please, thank you, excuse me. Not because I'm Canadian, because we're human. And in places of high stress, we should be more human to each other.
Grit begins with common humanity. And common humanity is when we actually recognize the soulful force in every single one of us.
See, success is not a result of what we occasionally do. Success is a result of what we do all of the time, every single day.
How can we live to 120 and have 119 great years and one bad day, right? That's the ultimate goal. And I truly believe that this is possible.
Our brains have this immense capacity to get things done, to create things, to develop things, to change what's already in front of us. That has happened historically through time and it continues to happen today.
We need to be strong, we need to be fit, we need to be able to stand and influence people.
We have to put down technology and experience life.
Humans crave meaning. We seek it. We're compelled by it.
So I want you all to reach a little bit bigger. Think that more is possible. Reach right out are there for the top. There's nothing that's stopping me. Let's do this.
Jackpots! That is worth talking about.
If I could just be in this community, my life would really start to work in a way that would be absolutely an unfair advantage over average.